Hey, we're live. So, hey everyone, welcome to Lunchtime with Anna. I could not get on today without singing happy birthday to this young man who turned, 36?
He's lying.
36. We're kidding. But we're going to sing happy birthday to him real quick. The kids had set up the office for him. He was so surprised. I'm sitting here. I'm actually working. And I wasn't able to turn around and say, surprise. But the kids were like, surprise. So here you go, Derek. And we're going to sing happy birthday real quick. Okay, so 1, 2, 3.
Happy birthday to you.
And I'm going to sing in Spanish for you. Feliz, feliz en tu día. Que Dios te bendiga. Que reine la paz en tu día. Y que cumplas muchas más. Guys, that will be the first and last time you guys ever hear me sing on air. Don't hear me because I can't sing. Yes, we're going to give them some cake. So happy birthday, Derek. We love you very much. God bless you. And God continue to bless you in all that you do. You know, you're incredible to so many of us in real life. He is in tears, guys. Don't let him tell him no. None of that in Lunchtime with Anna. And so, Derek, what's on your mind?
Well, not another but my first gift. I'm very blessed, and I really appreciate it. Wishes. And I'm ready to get this interview with Mr. John because that video I saw was
it was so nice. And I'll tell you guys, when I saw this video, I was like, no, there is living and then there's living. And John is living, because I was like, that's how we all need to be. Like just now, y'all saw how I sung for y'all, and I can't sing. I don't care. But the thing is that John had the moves. I was like, okay, he got the moves. He knows the whole routine. We're going to ask him about all of that. But now, Derek, before we go into John, I wanted to ask you real quick if you can give us a rundown on Crane Elite. If you don't mind, tell us a little bit about it.
We work under, well, let's say, agent under CCO, and we give you the written prep to become a crane operator. We also give you all the practical exams. Make you one of the best operators out there. We have job placement. Starting pay down here in Florida is $37 on up. Classes are not long. Written prep usually 4 or 5 days. Hands-on training is normally a day to maybe a week. It depends on you. Now, that's for people who have some type of experience in the crane industry. Those who do not, just come off the street and ready to go, it's usually a 10 to 2 week program that we'll set you up. We'll teach you how to break down cranes, set them up, teach you all the load charts. And if you have the right attitude, we have a placement for you and we'll put you in the right position to get your career going.
So if you'd like to reach out to us, at
CraneElite.com or Crane Elite Prep School on Facebook. You can call the phone number there. One of our program directors will give you information you need to know and get you going. We also do travel depending on how many people is interested in the class. We're nationwide, we even go overseas. So give us a shout.
Yes, And it so we'll be in Tennessee.
Upstate, Tennessee next weekend. We'll be in Jacksonville this weekend. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we can only take 24-hour notice and we can get you set up.
So we do travel and we're willing to do that. But as awesome as all of that is, and as we can all give you guys a job, right? Doing what you like to do or what you can learn to do, right? Let's talk about the man. But first, before I do that, I want to play this video and I'm going to share it real quick. You guys bear with me because I hardly ever share. So bear with me. This is it, right? Okay. So here we go. We're not seeing it. Hang on. Why not? Why isn't it playing? It's just playing out here. Let me get you more. All right, you guys bear with us. Like I said, I don't ever share screen. And I just practiced this right before. Coming on here. Give me 1 second. There we go. This was it. Okay. Now here I got it, guys. Device, I think it's it. Why aren't we playing? Hang on, guys. Let me see your device. Let me move the mouse. That's strange. Okay. So for whatever reason, we can't get in on. I'm going to try one more time. So this is what I'm gonna do. Since I can't get it on, I wanna share it with you guys this way. And I'm so sorry, I don't know why our internet's giving us a problem. And it seems to happen every time we're on air. So, anyways. It's weird, it's not giving me anything. Okay. Okay, so here we go, guys. Okay, so guys, and I'm sorry for the reason it's not working, but listen, guys, this video has over 1,000,002 views. John, what was your frame of thought? Where were you? How did this happen? Tell us all about it. And thank you for taking out of your busy schedule to come on my platform. I appreciate you.
Well, first and foremost, I need to say thank you for you for giving me the opportunity, because this is truly a blessing. The amazing thing actually about this video is it's actually 4 years old. It's actually a video I did back. I went to go to a Janet Jackson concert back in November of 2017. I had taken my son, who you see is on the left. I'm a huge Michael fan and a Janet fan. But my son was actually considering wanting to be a dancer. So I said, okay, if you want to be a dancer, let me go show you and let me show you the skill set of what it's going to take if you really want to do this. And, it was a warm-up show, so the guy was playing the music. So I, just said, I'm going to go have myself a good time. And as you can see, I'm a huge fan. I was a mobile DJ for 28 years, so it's not something that's uncommon to me. And after that, everybody takes photos and videos, so I didn't think anything of it. I was just having myself a good time. And by the end of the weekend, I'm getting phone calls saying, hey, John, you're going viral. Hey, John, you're going viral. So this actually is the third run of it actually going viral. If you take a look at the original post on Facebook, it actually has 65 million views.
Wow. What do you think?
Everybody I'm the most.
Go ahead.
Yeah. Oh, so I tell everybody I'm the most famous person that nobody knows.
Well, I beg to differ there. I beg to differ because I think you have made such a positive impact on people's lives, especially during COVID. We're going through pandemics. We needed a good smile, a good laugh. Because I was like, okay, I need to get up and I need to just get up and dance my, we actually did Bad. Actually, we did Michael Jackson too when I was Smooth Criminal. That's what it was, Smooth Criminal. We did a performance of that too, and I should probably do those moves too, see what people think. But just the way you were just like, I don't care, I'm doing what I'm doing. What was the reaction of the crowd around you?
Well, you saw there was obviously mixed reviews, and there's always going to be mixed reviews regardless of
really?
Wherever you go. Some people, mm-hmm. Applauded and cheered. Then you saw the two guys in front of me thought I was crazy. But what I've been trying to tell everybody who I've been responding to on, when you know who you are and whose
yes.
you are, you don't need to yes. worry about what anybody else thinks, because you can walk with that confidence that obviously, like you said, this dance video has connected with others. And obviously I feel like I feel comfortable dancing, that I have somewhat of a skill set, so I can walk in that boldness and in that confidence. So I was dancing for me, and everybody else just got the opportunity. I think that was one of the connection points that a lot of people said, that my freedom, yes. my joy, my dancing yes. like no one yes. else is watching. And then, like you said, that it just resonated. And that was the magic that I didn't see, because as I tell everybody, I was just being John. That was, this is what I do every day. You ask the guys here at work, this is where I'm at right now. I'm on lunch. But if you would ask them, oh, yeah, John sings all the time. John dances all the time. So I was just being me. And I really never thought that this would have such a impact where, oh, my God, I'm your spirit animal. You're my spirit animal. I needed this jolt of enthusiasm, so I've been trying to use it as a positive and try to bless people, because in reality, I think I'm the one that's gotten most blessed from it.
Wow, that's big. And I'm going to go to that question, because I like what you just said. I really like it. This is my question to you. You said you got mixed reviews. When I first saw this video, for me, it was, man, I need to be more like John. And I say that because, as many people know, I have a son who's been diagnosed with autism. And a lot of times he doesn't care what anybody says or thinks. He does what he wants to do. And I don't care. And I wish I can be that free, but society teaches us on that straight arrow and do things this way and that way. But when I saw that, it touched me in such a positive way, because I said, John, you don't understand what you just did in my life, in my world. I mean, I shared, Derek, didn't I share with you? I shared it with everyone I know. I'm like, you have to watch this if you haven't already watched it. Many people said, I love that video. I've seen it. I need that positive whatever. Some people were like, wow, you know, he didn't care who is, like, he was just jamming. And I'm like, that's what I'm talking about. That's how we all need to be. So for me, I just want you to know you're super inspirational. Derek, your opinion on that?
Me too.
And so you go back to say how this video has been a blessing to you, or this performance that you did that night, like just for yourself and your son. Y'all are relaxing. How was that? How has that been a blessing to you, to John?
Well, first and foremost, connected me with people that I never would have met before in my entire life. On the first video, like I mentioned, I tried to reach out to as many people as possible to let them know that the comment that they put down, I've actually read, and it impacted me. And then I tried to, as you can see on any of the posts, I do my best, but you know, when it gets to high numbers, it's very hard. But I want them to, one, understand that they're just as important as what so-called I did, that I'm not any different, but they have just as much value. And I wanted to let them know that the words that they're saying actually connect with someone else. And then I also wanted to know that they were giving me a gift as well. So, I mean, I'm speaking to people in Australia, Ireland, the UK, you know, so, you know, I'm just here in New York. I mean, now granted, I had desired to be as big Michael Jackson way back in the day when I wanted to be a performer, but it never worked out that way. But God, you know, is a miracle God, and kind of gave me that opportunity without having to do all the hard work that Michael Jackson or any other performer did. So that was, and then once again, just to see that what I actually do, the little small things can have a great impact. You know, we're called to be salt and light. And so in that aspect, I have been shining his light that I now have, the joy, the happiness I've now been able to give. And for, like you said, for a lot of people, their circumstances or the challenges that they've gone through COVID, they didn't see a lot of hope. So to see how this might have uplifted them, to encourage them to fight another day. What you guys might not know is I'm also the kids director for church where I worship. And we teach the kids three basic truths. And basic truth number one is I can trust God no matter what. So if I could help share some of these messages and give them that knowledge, that base, treat others the way you want to be treated is our third core basic truth. So between trying to use this as basically a tool to spread the good news as well as to encourage others, because in the world, you know, unfortunately, I mean, hey, we're seeing the Ukraine, right? We're seeing hate, we're seeing violence. Why can't we do the opposite and share love and joy and change the world like that through that capacity?
And I'm absolutely in love with the idea of everything you do even more, especially when it comes to the children. Children to me have such a special place in my heart, especially because I had to learn, right? I was already a very compassionate person, right? And I empathize so much with people, but I had to learn that even more with my special needs son. So I applaud you, because I was one time a youth pastor as well. And I know what it's like. to have to make it fun for them, teach them something new, and make it exciting. Sometimes you do have to get up and dance for them and do things you would normally not do in your everyday just to connect and get them, you know, to seek our Father and, you know, learn it in their own little minds, you know? So I applaud you for that. And I thank you for taking the time with the children, because so many people out there forget our youth. And our youth is so important. We have to be there for them. Now, my next question to you, actually, there was a question here, which I think you kind of answered, but we'll answer it again. Do you have a love for music?
Oh, without a doubt. It's ingrained in me. It's in my blood. And if you, like I said, if you were to put on a song and it was one of the things that moved me, you would see me either singing, just like I did when you played the video. I can't control it. It's just part of my DNA. So when there's a song on the radio and I'm in the car, you'll hear me singing. I'll even when we're stopping, I'm dancing in the car while the radio, not worried about anybody else. Some people give me thumbs up. Some people say, wackadoo, you know, but I'm one of my mindsets is that make every day your masterpiece. You know, just taking a look at COVID. We never know when tomorrow, you know, tomorrow is for us. You know, will God take us tomorrow? In fact, one of my classmates just recently passed away. And she actually commented on the video, and I wished her happy birthday maybe 2 or 3 weeks ago. And just like that, she's gone. So we're only here for a certain period of time. I want to live every day to the fullest. I don't want to. That's why sometimes you'll see some of the other posts that I do is just to remind people to do the things that you love. Love the people that you love. Love the people you love.
Absolutely.
I love you. I wish I should go to water. Right? I think everybody should raise and have those stories.
You know, and that's so true that you say that, because I think we hit a certain point in our life where it's just about that. It's just about love the ones that love you, the ones that don't, love them from a distance, and hey, we'll move on and enjoy every second of every breath that you have. And I'm really big on that. I'm like, you know, you don't want to leave an imprint saying there's so much I didn't do because I was so afraid. And I think that's what just really excited me about seeing you, your video, that I was like, man, you know, that's what it's about. And, you know, I even connect with you more to know that you believe exactly. See, people connect with what you're saying. And I'm seeing it over and over again on the comments, because you're the truth. You're real. That's what it is all about. That's living, because if not, we're not living. We're living for what? To please everyone else? At the end of the day, is it about them, or was it about you being happy and doing what you wanted to do to keep the world happy in your own world? If that makes sense. I don't know if that made sense. That was weird, but it made sense to me.
I'm with you. See, God has wired us, and He's commanded us to love. He's commanded us to love Him. Absolutely. And He's commanded us to love others. And if Absolutely. I'm not being my authentic self, then I'm really not loving God, because He's made each one of us fearfully and wonderfully made. He's made us as, you know, a masterpiece. So I need to let all of that shine, because there's no other I mean, my dad actually has the same name as I do, but my dad and I are totally opposite. You know, my dad, you would never would have seen on a video dancing the way I did. But he's still John Lawless, but he's not this John Lawless. And you're the only Anna the way that you're, and Derek's the only Derek that the way he's made, even though there's other Annas and Derek's. So we're really doing ourselves and God a disservice if we're not living to our true, authentic self. So we have to remember that we're fearfully and wonderfully made. Walk with that courage, because you will feel like you've left something on the table. And remember, He came, according to His word in John 10:10, it says that I've come to give you life and live it more abundantly. So if you're not living abundantly, then you need to take stock of yourself and say, okay, where am I not living abundantly? And is it because I've made a poor choice? Is it because I'm concerned about the opinions of others? Then I need to go back to basic truth number one, which is God. You know, I can trust God no matter what. God said that I'm His child. I made His sin. I have the seeds of greatness are not only in me, but they're in all of us. Now allow me to let them out because they're here to be a blessing to others. And now, because of the video, I've kind of seen how my gifting and love of music and dance has been a blessing to others. And I can't say thank you enough for everybody who's allowed me to touch their life like that. It really has truly touched my heart.
Wow. I'm just, I didn't expect, guys, and I want you guys to know something. I asked John, and I normally ask everybody I interview, you can send over a few questions or let me know what you want me to ask, because I want everybody I interview to be comfortable. John told me, let's just let it go, ask whatever, we'll see where it goes. I never saw this, but I pray for shows like this every week. And just to see it unfolding right in front of me is just confirmation. And Derek, you know what I'm talking about, because we have these conversations. It's just confirmation that my Father continues to be everywhere I am and continues to bring these amazing souls. Because, I mean, like I said, John's just sitting there and he's like, you know what? I don't care what y'all talking about. I'm getting up. I'm dancing to my Michael Jackson, and wait, and I got to do the spin and do the spin and everything. And then, because you reminded me of me, right? When I do anything like that, that I get all excited and woohoo. And then you just put up your glasses like, okay, that was my favorite part, believe it or not. I'm like, oh, I love it. I love it. Be you, forget the world. And I just love that because we're so busy pleasing other people. Okay. People attacking each other via social media, this party, that party, wars and pandemics and whatever else you got to deal with, that it's just refreshing to actually catch somebody just being happy. Because I think that's all it boils down to. So my question to you is, after that, did your son continue pursuing dancing?
Actually, he did not. He got distracted because that's what happened to me when I was that age as well. Had I known what I knew then, you know, I obviously would have took a path because I didn't know how hard success was and what it took. And that's what I was trying to tell him, is that you're going to have to give up, hanging out, playing the video game. You're going to have to give up maybe dating your girlfriend for a while or maybe think about relocating, because you're either going to have to be going to auditions every day in the city or go out to the West Coast. You know, so I was trying to show him the road of sacrifice. Now, luckily, I found the happy medium from my life when I had... because I went to a few casting calls, I didn't work out, and that kind of deterred me. So luckily, I found my happy medium, which was a mobile DJ company back in 1988 that fit for me, that I was able to do the entertaining that I like, but still be able to work like I am here now at the post office, and then also have a family. But you've seen all, you know, all the stories of all the great success people. A lot of people, you know, take a look at how much Beyonce had to sacrifice, or Michael Jackson, or you take any of these, and some of the areas of their other lives have been diminished, whether it's a broken marriage, whether it's, not having a childhood, like Michael sings about in, This Is My Childhood. So for me, I found what worked best for me, because as you were talking about, family was always my core value. I always wanted to be a dad, and I always wanted to be a husband. So I was able to continue to do that, but yet still be able to give the gift of entertainment at the level of that would work best for my family. It wouldn't detract, or I wouldn't feel like I've sacrificed too much of one thing in order to enjoy the other. So I was able to find a pretty good balance. So that would be the other thing also, is that everybody's got to be comfortable what's success for one person won't be success for another. So you have to define what you consider success to be.
I love
for
it.
You.
I love that mindset. John, I don't meet too many people that think like me, that are positive in that sense, because like I tell everybody, it's all in your mind, it's all in your hands. Just you can change the whole, your whole frame of thought and your whole life can change around just like that. Just like that, just being positive and just taking the negativity away from yourself. Now, do you read the question?
I did, actually. I was prepared just in case. I didn't know whether it was going to be asked. But I actually put something on the computer just in case they, that was the question. I thought they might. So,
I love it.
Is that okay?
Yes, it's okay.
Right, so
of
give me a
course,
second. Let me,
it's okay.
Okay.
Okay, guys. So he's getting the computer ready. He's about to give us some of his moves. He's ready. And thank you, Jamil, for asking that question. This is gonna
I'm
going
to try and move it over here so you
good.
Might be able to hear it.
To know to get under, you're stuck in the middle, and the pain is thunder. To know to get under, you're stuck in the middle.
The music, but I tried my best.
I think we caught most of it. You had me making moves over here too. Were you guys able, I want to know, for the listening audience, were you guys able to see that and hear that well or no? And while they're doing that, how exhilarating is it for you? Every time you turn around, you're like, look, I'm just gonna do it. Y'all better join in, or you better join in, because that's just the spirit that I have.
Well, sometimes the music speaks to me, like, you know, obviously Michael's got certain choreographed moves, but sometimes I'll listen to any song and then all of a sudden a move will come upon me. I try to find the rhythm or the words and try and find a dance move that connects with it. So that's combination of what happened the night of the show. Part of the choreography you saw actually is part of what you've seen the Jacksons do, and part of it because you have to also be mindset of where you are in the atmosphere. So obviously I don't have the same dance, you know, because usually when the Jackson performance, usually on a stage or in an auditorium, you know, but in being in a row of seats, you're limited with the things that you can do. Here in my office, I have a little bit more space, but that's also something to be mindful of too. But it's just letting yourself go, just enjoying the either the music or the moment or the people that you're with sometimes. Because obviously, think about it. Anytime you go to a party and you dance and you have fun, it's just a wonderful time and you won't forget it.
Absolutely. And John, I want to tell you a little secret that some of my followers know,
okay,
they really follow me. And I want to make this offer to you. As many people know, Lunchtime with Anna is connected with the entertainment industry. I know people in New York, coincidentally. I know people in Georgia, California, as well as Florida and other states, Louisiana, other states. If you're interested, I would love for you to submit to the Blackbird's Melody, which is one of the entertainment and production companies I am on staff with. But I'd also like to introduce you to a few people that I know in New York that are good people, of course. Like I tell people, in this industry, it's a very dog-eat-dog industry. And I'm sure you know this. You have to really watch your circle and really protect your space, right? So just weed them out and move on. No hard feelings. You know what I'm saying? Move on and continue living life. That's my advice to everybody. But if you're interested in acting, dancing, anything, let Lunchtime with Anna know. I will see what we can do to connect you somehow, because I know people don't meet coincidentally. Coincidentally, I wouldn't have it reached out to you. Coincidentally, we wouldn't be sitting here. I know this for a fact. Don't ever tell me that you're too old, because we're never too old to enjoy anything, okay? And we're never too old to start anything. And if you're willing to take that offer, I will gladly put in a word for you, and we'll find something that you could do.
Well, I believe, like I said, that I'm using this platform for whatever God wants me to do. So if it is to give the illusion, because if you've seen some of the comments, I've been compared to Danny DeVito, Sergeant Slaughter, I forgot, George Costanza. So that's the other mindset that I want to also help break, is that we don't judge the book by its cover here. Because I am overweight, gentlemen. You know, yes, I'm bald. But why do we need to put the labels on the people? Because you don't know what's on the heart of the inside of a person. So if that's a story that needs to be told to give confidence to some people who maybe their self-confidence has been shaken because of what other people have said, if that's the platform that God wants me to go to, once again, go back to finding their significance in Him, then I'm all for it. In reference to, dancing, I'm letting God lead this. That's why I haven't found, because I truly believe that this has been God ordained, because I had no intentions when I left the building on November 15th. So everything that's happened, I believe in God's call. So somewhere or not, Anna, I do believe that God wanted us to connect, because you're also the only podcast that I've ever been on. I've never been, in the past 4 years, I've been on Newsday, did it, which is a local newspaper here. I've been on Daily Mail TV. Steve Harvey's people reached out, but they never connected. Everybody's saying, oh, Ellen. I said, listen, no, she never reached out. So, obviously it's not where I'm supposed to go yet. But for whatever reason, God wanted me to speak to your audience, which is why I told you, whatever you feel the audience needs to hear from me, I'm here to serve you and your audience. It's not about me. I'm just John Lawless. I'm just a regular guy. But I am John Lawless's crisis ambassador. So if this is what he wants next for us, then I'm all for it. Whatever you need me to do. You're welcome to give out my phone number, my Facebook, my email. What I want everybody to feel like now John Lawless is their friend.
And one thing I do want you to know, eventually, I plan on branching out a separate Christian production company for fellow Christians, just to tell little stories, something that'll motivate somebody and inspire someone. So just always know you have a friend in me. You have a friend you can count on, because I really would like to see you in a lot of things that I'll be like, I knew it. I knew that we didn't connect just by chance. My next question to you is, what's next? If you have this opportunity again, would you? That's two questions.
All right. Well, I go to concerts all the time. In fact, I was supposed to go to a concert 2 weeks ago, but it got canceled because of the former wife unfortunately passed away, and they rescheduled it for May. But I have a concert to go to see actually Michael Jackson be performed over at the Patch Oak Theater. So I'm doing that all the time. In reference to what you just said, though, I actually just came away from Florida, which is why we couldn't do this last week. I was down at a 3-day personal development conference with the Maxwell leadership team. So I am a Maxwell leadership certified team member. So I have the ability to coach, to speak, to train, to do behavior assessments and the leadership game. So I definitely could see how that, once again, seeing how God is moving in a direction, that might be the way that we connect. What, like I said, I'm here to serve and add value. So whatever it is that I could do to help you and your organization grow, I'm all for it, Anna.
Amen. Am I on mute? And you know what? Amen. And I'm all for connecting. I wanted to ask Derek before we go, are there any final thoughts that you have? Because I know he really wanted to see you dance. So he's going to make me go back and play it again because he was on a call. And I was like, wait. And I'm like, you can't. We're live.
If I could ask you a question, where in Florida are you guys located?
Our company's in Bartow, but we also have our crane yards in Tampa, Florida.
So, if you know, you're asking, we're right smack in the middle of Florida somewhere. That's our location. Like, we're close to everything. We're close to Tampa. We're close to Orlando. So we're in that good county. Is it wet?
That's the reason why I was asking, because I will be in Orlando again next March for another conference. So hopefully between now and then we could make arrangements so we could actually connect face to face.
45 minutes from the airport.
Absolutely. We're 45 minutes away from the airport in Orlando and about the same distance to Tampa. So just know that whatever you need, John, you call us. I'm telling you, you got some friends in town, and I'll tell you, Derek has taken me to all the places, guys. I'm not gonna lie, I've been cheating on my diet. I'm transparent. I say how it is. He's been taking me to some of the most awesome restaurants with chicken wings, soul food. Where's we gone? We gone to Southern Florida cooking. I forget, just all kinds of restaurants. And this is not like McDonald's or Wendy's or Arby's. No, I'm talking about mom and pop's good food in made fresh type of cooking. So we will gladly take you around to these places. I can take you to a pizza shop, but I know no pizza place is like in New York. Y'all's pizza is like no other. So we all know that. Y'all just made that pizza. They're really enjoying you today. And this is one of those interviews that has been the most satisfying and refreshing in a very long time, I think. And refreshing because we need that joy in our life. Guys, he's just inspired me. I'm going to get up. I'm going to go to concerts, and I'm just going to start dancing too. I'm scared to go to concerts because of the pandemic, but after it's all done and over with, I'll take a swing into a concert. Y'all might see me next on the video and be like, hey, wait a minute, is that Anna? So, but John, I really do want to connect on a personal level, while joking aside, and be able to work with you in more than one way because, you know, and again, remember, more than likely because of the positions I hold in society, certain things I don't affiliate myself with, even in the entertainment industry. So, you know, I can bring you along, you know, and just know that that door is open. Anytime, just let me know. I'm ready, Anna. And you know, I know people that maybe other people don't know. And I make sure closed doors are like, I tell you, don't go in that door. That's a bad door. Don't ever go in that door. So, but I have really enjoyed this. I'm going to try to play this video. I want to play it one more time because I really need them to see the joy of what it is to live before we go. And then I'm going to ask one or two more questions after the video. So let's try it one more time, see if it works this time. And then after that, I'm not sharing. Well, that might have been the problem. You know, whether you believe it or not, Crisscross is a good one to dance to. Just so you know, that the 90s was like my time.
If
so
I was younger,
was a good one.
I would have
to me,
jumped.
Really, you're gonna hold me up to that, huh? What is going on with the signal? Are you there? Hang on, it's probably me.
I got you.
You said if you were younger, you would have probably jump. So you were gonna say something?
Oh, I was just saying, when I was younger, I would have jumped, but I was 3 days away from being 50 there, and once again, making the wise choice, I got to know what I can do and what I can't do, and that just wasn't for me. Back in the heyday, I would have kept going, I would have kept dancing, but I got to be selective now in the ones that I choose to enjoy in that atmosphere. If I was at the club, same thing, and there's sometimes that when I go to the club, I'll dance to certain songs, but there's certain other songs. You know what? Time to go to the bathroom, or time to go get water, and then come back when they play one of my jams.
I need to catch my breath. I love it. You have been one of the interviews I have enjoyed the most. John, I appreciate you taking the time to come on here. I want to ask a few questions, whatever you make as contact for prayer, as just helping somebody, or just to connect with you on your page, because he does share the video on his page, guys. I've seen it myself. I actually got the video from his page because people post so much on my page, I lose stuff. So, can you give us any contact info for you know, so that they're able to reach you?
Yes, sure. They can go to Facebook, ask me to friend me. My name is John Lawless Jr. right there on the screen. My email address is my last name, Lawless, unlimited, @gmail.com. My phone number is 516-903-9231. If you text me, just say, hey, I was on lunchtime with Anna. This way I know how I connected with you. I am God's ambassador. So if he's connected me for some way, to either reach out to you for spirit of encouragement, spirit of prayer. I do my daily devotions usually early in the morning. So if I know that you're going, you know, if you're having an issue with healing, I'll try and send you a healing scripture or something that applies to that. If right now is one of my youth kids would just said, you know, he's struggling with making mistakes. And then I you know, once again, I told him, listen, you're forgiven. You know, you have to understand that everything was paid for at the cross. So you need to just God says, hey, I don't know what you're talking about. I forgave you of that. So if God can forgive you, you need to forgive yourself. And that's probably one of the hardest things that we as Christians do, because we don't have the ability to erase it the way God does. He says it's done and it's over with, but we still carry it with us. And then we got that other guy talking to us. Oh, yeah, do you remember when you did that? Well, you got it. That's when you got to know. That's why you got to know God's word. And that's why you could say, you know what? That's right. But it was paid for on the cross. So whatever I can do to be add value and be an asset to you, Anna, Derek, or your lunchtime community, I'm here to serve.
Absolutely. And I want to add to that. If you could tell that young man, I dealt with that myself growing up and getting older. And until I turned around and I started speaking up and saying, you know what? This did happen to me. I made this mistake and I spoke about it. He couldn't use it against me anymore because now I told on myself. And I have no problem with, to this day, I'll tell him myself, I'm like, oh yeah, I did that. And I'm sorry, but you know, I make mistakes too. You know, we're just made of flesh, you know, so we're going to stumble from time to time and it is what it is. But guess what? I get up and I move on and my focus is on the Lord. Or not on anything else in this of this world, because that's not going to take me anywhere. So, and John, I do Bible study on Tuesday. I do a Bible study on Wednesday. We do, it's a book club on Tuesday. It's Bible study on Wednesday, and it's Bible study on Thursday also. It's two different platforms, but you can see it on mine. There's Forgiving Fridays, which Christy Marshall does on Fridays. Friday mornings at around 7 o'clock. And we do inspirational Sundays. This Sunday, I will be teaching, Derek inspired me on that. It's one of my favorites in the Bible, the book of Malachi, because it teaches us so much. So I will be teaching about that on Sunday. Christy's more of a pastor-like, evangelical type. I more teach because I like people to learn it from beginning to end. We have two totally different day and night ways of teaching, but we work together and that works for our ministry. As well as this Monday, she'll be doing Motivational Monday at 7 o'clock in the morning. So if you'd like to get involved, you are more than welcome to get involved. We always appreciate that. And, you know, because it might just change one person's life. That's all we care about, just changing one person's life. We don't need a million viewers, a million followers, but we do need them to follow Christ and know that Christ loves them, and that's enough for me, you know? So with that being said, thank you so much for giving all your information, guys. If you guys could, please reach out to him. Let him know that Lunchtime with Anna sent you. And even if you just don't, just watch that video, because let it be a good, positive motivation to continue moving forward and continue to just do your thing and just be like, you know what? I am going to tell. I did this. And you know what? I'm not perfect. But guess what? It is what it is. And guess what? I still follow Christ. And guess what? I still want to make it through those gates of heaven, because that's what it's all about. At the end of the day, that's all I care about. I know that's all John cares about. I know Derek and everybody else in this room, my children who are here too today. So with that being said, God bless you guys. Love you guys very much. Next week, we will have two politicians in Lunchtime with Anna, and the two politicians will be, one is Valencia Stovall, who is running for, I believe it's Congress in the state of Georgia. The second one is Mark Bell, who knows politics very well. With that being said, I will see you guys next week. A huge hug to everybody. John, thank you so much for taking out of your busy schedule, and say hello to everybody on that post office on behalf of Lunchtime with Anna and Derek, of course.
Thank you, John.
Host. God bless you. Bye.
My pleasure. Thanks, guys.
Thanks, guys.
Bye-bye.